Well, joining us now for his views on the emergency and the political debate that we are seeing now on the anniversary of the emergency, Mr. Yashwant Sinha. Thank you, sir, very much for speaking to us. Sir, the Prime Minister is saying that the emergency is a black spot on the nation, and I'm sure you would agree that it was a very sad chapter of our history. But a lot of people would say that what we are seeing now in terms of the lack of press freedoms in the country, that the threat to journalists, the threat to freedoms generally is as bad. Would you agree?
Yes, I'll agree entirely with what you have said. The emergency of 1975-77 was indeed a black chapter in our democratic history, and nobody, absolutely nobody, can say anything to condone it. But that being so, the present day conditions are reminiscent of what prevailed during those 2 years of the emergency. And you know, Indira Gandhi subverted the constitution by constitutional means. She showed how emergency could be imposed. The present Prime Minister has not exactly subverted the constitution. He has subverted the institutions of the constitution, institutions of democracy, and created emergency-like situations. I heard him talk about how the Supreme Court was afraid of what is happening to the Supreme Court today. So take any institution of democracy, Vishnu, you will find that the institutions have been severely compromised. And if there was the atmosphere of fear during the earlier emergency, there is an atmosphere of fear today of the undeclared emergency, which is what everyone is experiencing in the country today.
Mr. Sinha, a lot of people would say that the undeclared emergency you referred to is at least partly being played out on the internet, on social media, on Twitter, on WhatsApp messages. Do you believe this is a deliberate effort to spread fear in institutions and to challenge people who have any opposing point of view?
Absolutely. I mean, whenever I have said something which does not suit the so-called bhakt of the Prime Minister, then I am trolled. You know, they abuse me in the vilest possible language. And look at what happened to the External Affairs Minister, Sushma Swaraj, recently, when she was trolled so badly. And all those trolls are BJP trolls. So unless there was some indication from the top, this thing would not have happened. So social media is being today thoroughly and absolutely thoroughly misused to spread falsehood, to denigrate reputations, and to spoil the entire atmosphere, democratic atmosphere of this country.
Again, talking about the fear, do you believe that fear, whether it's online, on Twitter, on WhatsApp, or even in statements, is linked to keeping communities apart? The reason I ask this is if you look at the Sushma Swaraj case, some of the remarks were horrific. One of the remarks included a reference to her so-called Islamic kidney. She's had a kidney transplant. And trying to communalize or make this entire passport issue, which actually is a fairly small issue, into a religious issue. And if you don't agree with a majoritarian standpoint, then you are labeled. You are labeled in this horrific manner. Imagine a minister of the government, no less, being accused of having an Islamic kidney, which is why she's taken a particular standpoint. What does this reflect?
No, it's horrible. It's horrible in the extreme. I said something about Jammu and Kashmir recently, and someone accused me on social media saying that I probably take money from the Congress party, and now I have started taking money from Pakistan. So what is happening in social media is objectionable in the extreme. And you are absolutely right, Vishnu. Indira Gandhi's emergency was a political step. This time, the undeclared emergency has a very high content of communalism, and that is what makes it more dangerous. You can fight a political emergency, and indeed we fought the political emergency, and Indira Gandhi was compelled to lift it and hold elections in which she lost. But this undeclared emergency has such overtones of communalism that it is dividing the society, it is creating, spreading poison in society. People of different communities are looking at each other with a great deal of suspicion, and nobody is prepared to trust anybody else.
Mr. Sinha, do you believe the timing is not isn't just a coincidence? Yes, it is the anniversary of the emergency, but do you believe that this is a deliberate effort by the BJP to make the emergency into a real issue ahead of 2019 to counter the rhetoric from the Congress and others that they are threatening basic freedoms?
You know, they might like to take the debate in that direction, but I am absolutely certain that they will not succeed for the simple reason that, as I have said elsewhere, emergency was imposed and then lifted in this country some 43 years ago. The modern generation does not have any recollection of emergency. It is history for them. And more importantly, Indira Gandhi was personally punished for imposing emergency in this country when she lost the 1977 elections so badly. So you can't revive that today and say, you know, that should not have happened. Yeah, that happened. The people who are responsible for it have paid the electoral price for it. It is part of our history now. But today we are living through fear. Institutions of democracy have been severely compromised, and that will be the issue in the next election, not Indira Gandhi's emergency.
So a lot of people would say that unlike the emergency, we still have a vibrant opposition. We've got political parties who argue and say whatever they want to. They may live in an era of fear, but in the emergency, you've had the opposition locked up in jail. So there is an essential difference now that perhaps the emergency was more severe. Would you agree?
Well, I'll agree only partly. The opposition is able to raise issues if they are allowed to in parliament and elsewhere. But you are also, Vishnu, aware of the fact that in the last session of parliament, votes of no confidence moved by various political parties were not taken up because the house was not in order. Now, that is one of the fundamental responsibilities of our of parliament, of Lok Sabha, to assure the people of the country that the government of the day enjoys a majority in Lok Sabha. Now, that majority was not allowed to be tested. Not that the government would have lost, but they even ran away from the debate. So, while nobody has been put behind bars for in the manner in which it was done in 1975, there is this, as I said, all-pervasive atmosphere of fear. People are scared. People are scared to talk. Even cabinet ministers are not spared. And the situation is therefore in many respects far worse than it was in the declared emergency of Mrs. Gandhi.
One final question to you, sir, about my community of journalists. Last year, we saw 11 journalists murdered. Three of these murders, Gauri Lankesh, for example, directly related to their work, 46 cases of attacks on journalists, 27 cases of police action, including arrest and cases filed. Do you believe we face the gravest threat to independent journalism in the history of India now?
Yes. I think the journalists today, especially independent-minded journalists, are in the direct line of fire. Without taking names, may I also point out of so many senior journalists who have lost their job in recent years only at the behest of the government. It is a well-known secret here in Delhi. And journalists are being targeted. Those who do not fall in line are the worst victims. And therefore, the media, unfortunately, large sections of the media have been so scared that they are only towing the government line, even going steps ahead of the government and supporting the government. I mean, this kind of situation, I lived through the emergency. The media, in the manner in which it exists today, was not there. We only had Doordarshan and the All India Radio. But today's situation is very bad, very dangerous, because in the so-called independent media houses and channels are giving a totally misleading picture of the prevailing situation. And many people would tend to believe what's happening. So it's not merely the social media, it is the electronic media, it is the print media also, which has been completely subdued, suppressed, and made to toe the line.
Mr. Sinha, thank you very much for speaking to us.